Hey guys, it's me, your piano roadmap guide. Welcome back. Today we're talking about ways to improve your sight reading. I love sight reading. It's one of my favorite things to do, and I think it's because I'm pretty good at it, so it doesn't feel like a chore. And I don't want to oversimplify this too much, but I think I'm good at it because I've always done it. My three older brothers took piano before me, and so I had all of their more advanced books to try to play through. I definitely wasn't always successful. I didn't follow any sight reading rules. I just did it because I enjoyed it. But there are more direct and efficient ways to improve your sight reading, and we're gonna go through those today. First of all, let's define sight reading. Sight reading is not the same as reading music. Being able to read music just means that you're able to decipher the notes and other symbols on the page. Sight reading is the ability to read and play music at first sight without any prior practice. And being able to sight read well can honestly make or break your whole piano journey. If every single piece that you play feels like an absolute chore to learn, it's gonna feel pretty tedious at times. But if you're able to find a mix of literature, some that are quite difficult to learn but satisfying to practice, along with some easier stuff that's fun to play and just feels good to play, I believe you'll enjoy your journey much more. Anyway, if you're wondering why your sight reading is not as good as you want it to be, ask yourself four questions. Then honestly answer them and act accordingly. The first question is, do you know your note names on the staff, and can you recognize them and find them instantly without thinking?
C. B. G.
If it takes you a while to find your notes on the piano, this is the first thing that you need to work on improving. Get some flashcards or make your own. I like these Bastion flashcards that I've linked below because they're simple and they're inexpensive. Then you've got to just drill them until you know them. And remember, naming the notes is just part of the solution. The other part is being able to quickly find the notes on the piano. So when you learn these, make sure you also review them so they get lodged back into your long-term memory. The second question to ask is, do you know your key signatures? Do you know how to play your scales, arpeggios, and chords in all the different keys? If you can't yet, no worries, because next week I'm starting a 12-week challenge. In every lesson, we'll be focusing on one key signature. We'll learn or review the scale, arpeggio, and popular chord progressions for that key. We'll practice some sight reading and learn a new piece together, all in that same key. I'll also give you a list of other pieces in different levels that you can play. If knowing and playing in different key signatures is a weakness for you, make sure to come back next week and we'll get better together. The third question to ask yourself is, do you recognize the shape of intervals and chords on the page and on the piano? Being able to recognize shapes on the staff is a broader level of reading music. So we can read each note individually for a close-up look, and then we can take a step back and notice the distance between notes. This speeds up your sight reading because now you have two resources or data points to pull from. So a good way to practice this is to first learn to recognize intervals on the staff. And again, we want to be able to recognize them instantly. So here are our seven intervals, and you can see that they each make a different shape. One thing that might help you is to notice that even intervals, seconds, fourths, sixths, and octaves, go from a line to a space note or a space to a line note. And odd intervals, thirds, fifths, and sevenths, go from line to line or space to space note. So that's part one, being able to recognize these quickly on the staff. Then you want to be able to quickly play each interval on the piano, no matter what your starting note, And also, learn to feel what shape each interval makes in your hand. By being able to recognize intervals on the page, then instantly know how that should feel in your hands, you can see how that will speed up your sight reading. It's the same thing with chords. A simple major chord looks like a snowman on the staff, and you can memorize what it feels like on the piano. So I've been showing you examples on the white keys only. The shapes change when we include black keys, but we'll get to that in our 12-week challenge. Now, the fourth question I want you to ask yourself is, can you hear the notes on the page without playing them on the piano? What do you think this sounds like? Well, the notes are just stepping up, aren't they? Bum, 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 bum. What about this? Here's our starting note, then it takes a big leap down, a fifth, and then just steps up, like our example from before. So, how can you get better at being able to hear how things go in your head just by looking at the notes? Answer: oral skills. If you're always practicing by yourself, I'd suggest that you take some music that you haven't played yet and just look at the notes on one staff. Try to sing the pitches that you see. Then play it on the piano and see how close you were. If you are far off, try to sing it through again, then check yourself. So keep doing this as a little warm-up every day and your ear or aural skills will improve. Now, if you have someone in the house that can help you and knows a little bit about piano, you can turn away from the piano, don't look, and have them play an interval, blocked or separated, then see if you can guess what interval they're playing just by hearing it. This can be quite difficult at first, so just start with two different intervals, maybe a second and a third, and have them switch randomly between those two. Then once you feel comfortable with that, then add the fourth, and so on. So, those are the four questions that I want you to ask yourself if you're having trouble with sight reading. And hopefully I've given you enough actionable steps to really improve your reading. But honestly, if you say, I don't want to do all that, I just want to sight read for fun, I support that, and you will improve if you read through new music regularly. If you sight read regularly and make sure that you're solid on these four items, you will progress just that much faster. And one last little tip, when you're reading music, your eyes should be scanning ahead and up and down. They're not just zoning in on one single note. So read a normal book and pay attention to how far ahead your eyes move from what word you're actually on. So read ahead and scan. Okay, so let me know how this goes because I know sight reading can be a very frustrating experience for some. Have a wonderful week and I'll see you at our next lesson when we start our 12-week major key challenge.